Happy morning to my all friends around the world. I am Dr. Tushar Choksi. I am practicing as a freelance consulting anesthesiologist in Vadodara city in Gujarat in India since last 32 years. Today I am going to give you the glimpses of the anesthetic management of geriatric patient with pacemaker for TURP. So this topic is very, very near to my heart because I have completed 50 patients in my lifetime. I'm basically a uro anesthetist. I give more anesthesia in urology, ENT and laparoscopy. So this is the topic I want to tell you about in detail. So this topic tells enter three weapons, like anesthetic management of one is geriatric patient with pacemaker and for TURP. So my lecture outline will be, we are dealing with the three things like geriatric patient, TURP and pacemakers. In geriatric patient, I will go through the definitions of geriatric patients routinely when we are encountering in our anesthesia practice. What are the physiological changes occurred in our geriatric patients and what they say about themselves, that what they come to our pre-anesthetic checkup, then what they want to tell us. Second thing is operations, that is a TURP. TURP means transurethral resection of the prostate or bladder tumor. And it deals with the urology and its definition, what is the nerve supply. So we can have the other way of around the nerve blocks and everything. Intraoperative consideration. And basically this operation is mainly because of the cautery and pacemaker. So use of cautery, whether we are using bilateral, unipolar or holmium laser. And third thing is pacemaker. Pacemaker is the main concern about these geriatric patients, about their definitions, indications or for implant of pacemaker, details and how to read this pacemaker, code pacemaker form. When we are dealing with the pre-anesthetic checkup, then we have to take the complete history, physical examination, laboratory investigation, pacemaker details and tailor-made anesthesia. And what things to remember about pacemaker and cautery, response to pacemaker to cautery. Cautery, this electromagnetic rays, what they do on the pacemaker. Pre-operative period, what we have to take in consideration. For pacemaker also, for this geriatric patient, what should be remembered. And even in post-operative period also, what we should be cautious about this geriatric patient. And how to prevent the cautery effect in this type of the operations. In para-operative period, what anesthesia drugs giving effect for this TURP. For geriatric patient and with pacemaker, what will be the words for the temperature and shivering, which monitors we are going to do, some of the words about the fluid administration, and even in post-operative career, what type of the analgesia we are giving and what type of the monitoring. And I will say about my experience, then I will say about summary and conclusion. So these are the roadmap of my lectures. So I'll start my lecture. So who are the geriatric patient? Most of the world countries have accepted the chronological age of 65 and more as a definition of geriatric patients. So whatever way, geriatric patients we consider in the definition of WHO that more than 65 years is a geriatric patient. And in that they have divided in the three groups, elderly, aged and a very old. Elderly from 65 to 74, aged is 75 to 84 and old is 85 to more. But always remember that old age is not a disease. So whenever old age patients, geriatric patients are coming into your practice or for giving anesthesia or for surgery, so you do not consider that these patients are very old, so they are having a multiple disease. But old age is not a disease. And these are the changes occurs during our lifespan from adolescents to young to even geriatric age. When our age is advances, there are age-related physiological changes. And what happens after 65? There are mainly three groups of physiological changes occurred in our body. First, changes in the autonomic functions and cellular homeostasis, like temperature, blood volumes, and endocrine changes. These geriatric patients are very prone to or very sensitive to temperature, blood volumes, or some of the endocrine changes, like they're prone for diabetes, they're prone for the thyroid disorders like that. Then reduction in the organic mites like brain, liver, kidneys, and bones and muscles. They all shrink as the age advances. And reduction in the organ functions like lung volumes and heart volumes. So each and every systems are affected in geriatric patients, like cardiovascular, respiratory to genitourinary, gastrointestinal, endocrine, skin and musculoskeletal system, nervous system, body temperature, immune system, and even their cognitive functions and psychological changes. So these are the changes occurred mainly in the brain, heart, neck, lungs, and skeletal. In this lecture, I'm going to focus on the enlargement of the prostate for the TURP and patients is geriatric patients having a pacemaker. So listed are the physiological changes occurred in our body of geriatric patient. Now I have created one poem. What geriatric patients comes to this operation, what they tell? They tell us, I cannot see, I cannot pee, I cannot chew, I cannot screw. Oh my God, what can I do? My memory shrinks, my hearing stinks, no sense of smell, I look like hell, my mood is bad, can you tell? My body is drooping, have a trouble with popping, the golden years gone with loss of bone, I am everywhere, handle with me care. So this poem will tell you how geriatric patients are to be handled in our during anesthesia time. Now, first we have learned about the geriatric patient. Now, second set is transurethral resection of the prostate, TURP. What is TURP? TURP is an endoscopic surgical removal of the prostate in a man having symptomatic bladder outlet obstruction secondary to benign prostatic hyperplasia. Whether the patient is coming for the benign prostatic hyperplasia or not, sometimes they want a surgical resection of the bladder neck because of the stricture of the urethra. And this resection of the prostate is with the diathermy plus with the irrigation fluid. And here we are using the cautery. And these are the basic applied anatomy and nerve supply. If you see that, okay, what are the nerve supply? So it comes from the prostatic plexus, which originates from the hypogastric plexus. And the afferent pain is from S2, S3, and S4. And pain impulse from over-distended bladder transmit from the sympathetic fibers that originate from T12, L1, and L2. So whenever there is a prostatic enlargement, at that time the bladder is full with the urine and the T12, L1, and L2 gives the pain impulses.